part what I saw, what most of the nation saw in these three games today. Let's just go over the one that just finished about 10 minutes ago, as of the time of this recording, which was the Washington football team losing by 8 points to the Buccaneers. Now, if you had, you know, your gambling stuff ready to go, you probably lost, because I think the over was like 9.5 or something like that. But, you know, for the Bucs to get out of this game, you know, barely, you know, no Mike Evans, you know, no Mike Evans really to be found, you know. I mean, Tom Brady did throw a touchdown to A.B. and to Godwin, and I think he threw one to Blake, too. I'm not sure. I don't remember. I think he dropped that or something like that. But, yeah, this really was, you know, Washington Super Bowl. I mean, nobody really expected the football team to even be here, and the fact that Taylor Heinicke got the start and played his ass off was just great. It was a really, really fun game until the very, very end. And, you know, the Bucs, they get to move on. They will have to go on the road probably one more time, you know, or potentially they could host the playoff game. Yeah. There's that possibility. With being the fifth seed, you can now host the playoff game. It could be possible. It might not be possible, but I don't know yet. What about the mid-game of the day, the middle of the day, the second game of the triple header? Rams-Seahawks. Now, the Rams just suffocated the Seahawks. I mean, this is a completely different story than the story we had 2 weeks ago. Jared Goff only completed 9 passes. He wasn't even supposed to be starting. He wasn't even supposed to be playing. He had a broken thumb. John Wolford got knocked out early on in this game. And then the Seahawks offensive line decided to collapse. Defense couldn't stop Cam Akers. You know, when Jared Goff was completing passes, they were big passes down the field, and this is what I was afraid of. This is what everybody was afraid of. The Seahawks, you know, just bending over backward and completely failing to get any momentum going. I mean, Russell Wilson was not cooking up, you know, the heat. He was cooking up cold, because it was just cold air. Cold air. You know everything about cold air, right? Cold air, it's just nothing. They wasn't doing nothing. They weren't able to do anything on offense. And it's a damn shame. It's a damn shame. And the Rams, they will have to either go on the road to the Packers, or they might go on the road to face somebody else. Could be the Saints. Could be the Bucks, maybe. Who knows? You never know. And then last but not least, Josh Allen. The Bills have won their first playoff game in 25 years. Now, I said that the Colts didn't really belong in the playoffs on Friday night, but they played their asses off. They did play very well. It was just some dumb decisions by Frank Reich and company to, you know, there was just some questionable decisions. And then there was some even more questionable plays happening. I mean, you got the analytics coming into play with going for two for no reason. You know, just that's a no-no. That's a no-no right there. You know, just take the points. It's very simple. Take the points. When you have to, you need to, I mean, the Colts had the ball for like 30 minutes in this game. They had the ball over half the game. And, you know, you got to take the points when you need them. You can't be going with analytics and stuff like that. You know, people have been throwing this word around a lot lately, analytics. You don't need all that. Just be smart. Take the points when you need them. I know Blankenship missed a field goal. It was a doink, by the way. There were two doinks today. One in the Washington game, too. But, you know, you gotta take the points. This is just bizarre right there. You don't do that. And, I mean, it was just completely inept on all accounts. I mean, y'all know what Phillip Rivers be doing. He makes dumb throws sometimes, you know? He does. He really game too, to where it's like, oh, this is a fumble. Ref said it's not a fumble. Ref then said it is a fumble. I don't know what in the world was going on at that point. I was just like, can we get back to the game, please? What's going on? Is this a catch? Is this not a catch? There were moments today where the refs took too damn long to get things, you know, smooth, quick, moving. I was wondering, I was like, wait, this game is like 3.5 hours long. What's going on here? And, you know, refs just got to get a little bit better, man. But that's all. That's just ref ball in a nutshell, man. But yeah, Bills, they got what they needed done. You know, Josh Allen went off and started playing football and started going off on teams, just playing out absolutely incredible. And the Bills will get to host another playoff game. Now that is great. The Super Bowl may be going through Kansas City in the AFC, but hey, it could go through Buffalo. It could go through Buffalo. But we'll find that out tomorrow, who the Buffalo Bills will be facing, since there is two wild card games left on the AFC side. So,